Good morning, friends. Today's topic is Image Segmentation. Myself, Karkalali, working as assistant professor in CEC department. What is image segmentation? Okay, image partition an image into meaningful region or object is called as image segmentation. We are going to divide an image into sub-image and make it as more meaningful and more useful for further processing and for the classification. That is also called as image segmentation. There are two major categories, supervised segmentation and unsupervised segmentation. In supervised segmentation, we need some prior knowledge, okay, about textures or objects or any other thing. We need to have some prior knowledge. In unsupervised segmentation, no prior knowledge is needed to perform segmentation, that is partition an image into meaningful region. We need some prior knowledge for supervised segmentation. We don't need any prior knowledge for unsupervised segmentation. Okay, this is an example for image segmentation. So here I am enhancing the paper image. Okay, also I am going to fill each object with the different colors and I am going to segregate each an object clearly. This is also another kind of segmentation. You are going to separate an image into tables, sofas. So we are going to make it in different colors. We are going to differentiate an object. We are going to make an image more meaningful. We are going to partition an image into meaningful region. Okay, that is the example 2. Here in example 3, image contain different textures. So for in a cloth we are having different textures, right? So if there is any flaws in a cloth, then we are able to identify with the help of segmentations. Okay, so we are going to divide an image into 4 different partitions with the 4 different colors. We are going to identify the regions. Here some color images. Here we are going, when examining the color images, we are going to recognize only the faces of an human being, only trees region, river region, mountain region, starfish background, horse image. In cat image, we are going to extract only object, particular object in an image, and also it is possible in color images. Okay, this is the segmentation example. Here some goals. We are going some grouping. We are going to group some similar pictures. Okay, it is another way. We are going to group some grassland containing similar pictures. We are going to group the grasslands and the cricketer shirt and the pant in the same color. It is a similar object. So we are going to similar looking pictures. We are going to make it as a group. We are going to group together. Okay, that is also bottom up process, in the sense we are going to do the processing in a bottom up manner. That is called as bottom up processing. These are all the goals of segmentation. We are going to separate an image into coherent object, right? So image into, we are going to make the image into animals. Animal, we are going to draw the image. In human, we are going to extract the object, human beings, roads, grasslands, etc. So what is the overview? What we are going to do? So what are the techniques present? So what are the techniques? What are the applications is going to match? So several techniques like edge-based technique. We are going to mark the edges only. Color-based techniques, based on the color it is going to address. Texture-based, disparity-based, motion-based, and also it is going to apply on the images like document images, medical images, range images, biometric images, and texture images. What is edge-based technique? Okay, here the image contain color printing. We are going to identify only the edges, so boundaries. We are going to mark the boundaries, and afterwards we are going to classify and analyze the particular image. This is called as edge-based technique. Next one is for region filling technique. Okay, afterwards I identify the boundaries of the regions. I am going to fill those boundaries with some colors, right? So this is color based technique. Here we are going to use color representation, that RGB, CMYK. Okay, for displaying we are going to use red, green, blue. For printing we are used to cyan, magenta, yellow, gray. Okay, then like a device dependent colors, lab space, color spaces, all different color space we can use. These are all the color space conversions we are going to use. So we are going to use some color space and some matrix sentence or some color spaces with the help of R, G, P with some spaces. We are going to convert YAQ into XY, YAQ image into RGB image, Y dash UV, digital TV image into RGB images. Okay. These are all texture based technique. Okay, I already explained what is texture. There is some differentiation in cloths that based on the textures in the cloths. So we have visual arts. Texture is a precise surface quality on an art surface. Okay, that is mentioned as different textures. This is disparity based techniques. Okay, to identify the images or keep one above one. So we are want to identify the distance of each image to each image. So distance from the pixels. So I am able to identify. These are all motion. In the image I am going to identify the image with the help of motions. Here document image. In a particular document there is some images present. I want to neglect the text and I want to extract only the images. I already explained purely medical images in the last video lecture. So we are going to identify the abnormal region by applying some partial differential equations, some snake based vectors, any support vector machine, any algorithm we are going to identify. Active contour model is used and we are going to identify the region. This is range based image, okay, where it is going to the ground truth images, where the intensity images were. So I am going to identify the ranges of a particular images. This is biometric images, like for fingerprint, faces and iris image, we also need segment. I want to segment those regions. With the help of those, I am going to identify the biometric of a particular person. So what are all the algorithms we are going to apply? So just I explained what are all the regions we are going to apply the image segmentation algorithm. So what is the image, what are all the image segmentation algorithm present in our image processing? So first I am going to explain you some algorithm called as moving window concept. I am going to use the 3x3 corner. I am going to move with the neighboring pixels. I am going to move the particular window into 3x3 area pixels. Okay, I want to classify those images. Okay, afterwards here is the I am going to compute 3x3, I am going to compute particular value and I am going to fill in an output file. Okay, I am going to move and I am going to fill and I am going to compute for 3x3 kernel and I am going to fill till the next time I am going to fill next 3 till the end and afterwards I am going to from last end. So finally I get a segmented output file. This is the concept of using moving window. This is segmentation using clustering. Clustering is the similar picture. We are going to identify the grouping the similar pictures. Okay. So beer contain in a daddy beer image we are going to contain the R value, G value, B value of a particular region. How we are going to cluster? We are going to make it the group. We are going to group the grass lat into one group, a particular white region into one group, black region into one group. Okay. These are all the things we can able to measure. Next, here some k-means clustering techniques are available based on intensity or color essential for vector quantization of the image attributes. So intensity based cluster, this is color based cluster. Okay, I already explained the grouping based on the cluster value. So first I am going to explain the algorithms. So we are going to partition n data points into k disjoint subset containing n data points so as to minimize the sum of squares criteria. We are going to initialize randomly choose the k centroids. Okay, afterwards we are going the data points are assigned as k sets. Afterwards we are going to update the centroid value. Okay, here clustering by known centers. Here there are two clusters. We are going to identify the two cluster centers and finding the centers from the known clustering values. Okay, based on the cluster center we are going to identify the things. So first one is we are going to initialize the clusters. Afterwards we are going to group the pixels nearest to the particular clusters. Afterwards we are going to group those clusters. Okay. So repeatedly we are going to choose the cluster center until we get a desired result. Here some example. These are all the points. We are going to use the distance matrix Euclidean distance. So I am going to assign 3 clusters centers K1, K2 and K3. I am going to compute, I am going to divide into 3 different clusters. Afterwards, based on the Euclidean distance, I am going to update the cluster center. And afterwards, I am going to group these things. After there are several points may come. Afterwards, we are going to compute to the compute cluster center, and I am going to update the cluster center, and I am going to group those particular cluster centers. So overall, it is very simple method, and the convergence is low minimum of the error function. But overall, the disadvantages, it is memory intensive. We need to pick the k value, that is the central value. So initialization also very sensitive. So we need to concentrate on those things. So next, mean shift clustering algorithms. So this is the segmented landscape image. So these are the things which we are going to apply the modes or local maximum density in the future spaces. So this is the explanation. This is the cluster points. We are going to identify this is the search window, and this is my center of mass. So I am going to compute mean shift vector, and I am going to move the search window to the center of the mass. Afterwards, I am going to compute the center of mass again, and I am going to search the window. I am going to move the search window to the new area. Afterwards, I am going to compute the again center of mass. Afterwards, I am going to compute the search window move to the center of the mass until I get in desired result. So this is my desired result. So I am going to stop here. So this is clustered all data points in the attraction basin of Moore. Based on attraction basin, we are going to compute mean shift clustering algorithms. I am going to find features like colors, gradients, textures, and initialize the windows with initial feature points. And I am going to perform mean shift for each window until convergence. Merge windows that end up near the same peak for Moore. Here there are some examples of mean shift segmentation algorithm. The first image is the original image, and the second image shows the mean shift segmentation results. These are all the more results. Another example. So what is the advantages of using it? Is very robust in outliers and finding variables and just a single parameter we are needing. And the spherical cluster we are able to assume. But what are the disadvantages? Is the computationally it is very expensive for a particular region, and its output depends on the window size only. So what is region growing? I am going to identify the same pixel, the brightest pixel, and I am going to add those nearest pixels into them, and I am going to add this one. This is called region growing algorithm. So region growing, I am going to start with the seed pixel, starting with the seed, and it let it grow. Similarity measure, based on the similarity, it is going to combine. Here splitting and merging, and this is the particular region. I want to split the particular region into four, and afterwards the fourth region contains region of interest. So I am going to again divide into all 4-1, 4-2, 4-3, 4-4, and afterwards if it is present, the region of interest present, I am going to subdivide. Here this is my quadri example for split and merge. This is my original image. I am going to divide into four region. My area of interest present, nothing to merge. So I find this is my area of interest. I am going to again merge, and I am going to, based on the splitting non-uniform, I am going to merge again. Finally I get these two regions after some iteration. This is splitting and merging algorithm. So I am what are the steps involved in those algorithms I have explained here. And these are all the waterset segmentation results of waterset segmentation algorithm. So this is the performance measures we are generally used. If the ground truth is positive and test result is positive, then it is true positive. Both are negative, then it is true negative. If the test condition is negative and it is test gold standard is positive, then it is true positive. That like we are going to compute the positive predictive value, negative predictive value, sensitivity and specificity. So these are all the segmentation algorithms we can apply. So these are all the performance measures, continuation, true negative, true positive value computation. These are all the formulas, accuracy, error rate, underestimation factor, overestimation factors. That's all. Thank you.